everyone, it's Dylan Jones with Frontier Precision. Today I'm going to be showing you a new tool in Trimble Business Center version 5.40 called the Extract Line feature for curb and gutter. And so what this is, I guess you could call it, is an auto extraction method for generating brake lines on curb and gutter. I have an MX9 mobile scan here imported into my Trimble Business Center project that I want to extract some brake lines from. And so I'm going to do that using the Extract Line feature tool found in the Point Cloud tab. Before I do that, I'm just going to narrow in on a section of the data here rather than the entire thing. And that's going to be this curb section that I've already generated ground classification for and windowed in with a limit box. So to get started, I'm going to choose the Extract Line feature tool. Let that open up. And I'm going to be sure to choose the curb and gutter extraction type. Here I can change the line settings if necessary. I can give these lines a name and a layer, style, and color. I'm going to put these on my curb and gutter layer. And the next thing I'm going to do is define a cutting plane. So this is going to be a cross section across the curb. I'm going to find a spot somewhat in the middle of my data set. And I'm going to rotate the point cloud so that my curb is going north-south here, and define that cutting plane by clicking in this 0.1 text box, clicking on the towards the back side of the curb, and then in the street area so that I'm slicing through the curb. And that way I have a nice vertical cutting plane that cuts through the curb, and I can see that profile of the curb nice and clearly. So the next thing I need to do is define my curb pattern, which is represented by four nodes. So you'll see those four nodes here. Very simply, using the cutting plane view at the bottom, I'm going to click on the back of the curb, face of the curb, flow line, and then match into the street there. If I had a edge of pavement or edge of concrete or lip of the curb, I could pick that and represent that fourth node that way. And then now I'm going to define the extraction interval. So if you look up here in the 3D view, I have this white arrow which represents that extraction interval. So at this moment I have it set to extract every 25 feet down the road. And then I can also define a confidence. And so what this represents is the confidence of the match of the pattern versus the point cloud. So what's happening here is there's an algorithm that's matching the point cloud to the pattern that I defined here by the four nodes. And so if I want it to be more confident, I can boost this up. I like to use 95%, that way whatever it auto extracts is going to be super confident. If that falls below 95%, it's going to require some user input where I can change maybe the template nodes or just kind of redefine things. That way I have a good extraction at the end of the day. It does default to 90%, which is going to be pretty good as well. I just boosted it up to 95% to give me a little bit more confidence. And then finally, I'm just going to hit the extract button. So after hitting extract, it is now going every 25 feet down the roadway, matching that template to the curb point cloud. And if it gets anywhere where it is unsure or that template confidence drops below 95%, it will pause on me and allow me to redefine that cross section or that template. So you can see here as I zoom in, it's showing me where it left off here in the cutting plane view. So as I zoom in, you can see that I no longer have that well-defined curb shape, and that's simply because there is a driveway here where the curb has dropped, and it's unable to automatically match my template to what I have for point cloud at that area. So my options here are to redefine my nodes, or I can undo. I typically will undo this cross section here and redefine my last, basically the 25 feet prior. And if I need to change up my nodes, I can do that. I'll just show you really quick what that looks like. I can edit my template nodes and just click on each node, move them around if necessary. Now it actually did a really good job still at this point, but I could redefine where those nodes are placed and continue extracting if it ever does get hung up at a certain spot in the curb. But at this point, I have a driveway where I'm going to do some manual editing in that spot, so I'm happy here where it left off. Now, as I mentioned, I started somewhere in the middle of two driveways, so I want it to actually come back to this start point and work in the backwards direction. So I'm going to choose this switch direction button and allow it to go the other direction. So clicking extract to allow it to go that direction. And you can see it's going to get hung up here at this driveway. So I'm going to zoom in and see kind of where it left off. And there's actually a problem with the curb there. There's some damage to it. And you can see that here in the cross section. So I can, again, undo that, or I can move around these templates. I'm actually going to undo it so I can manually edit. Or in this instance, if I want it to go just up until it hits that damaged curb section, I can reduce that interval to maybe 10 foot and see where that white line gets me. That actually looks pretty good, so I'm going to have it extract that last 10 feet. There we go. See, it automatically went forward to the curb drop or the driveway. I'm going to undo that last section and hit the finish button. So now I'm at the QA/QC portion of things. I can see the preview of my four brake lines. If anything looks weird in between, I would just edit those a little later on. So overall, things are looking good. I can use this post QA/QC tab to ignore certain brake lines. So if you actually don't want that fourth node, which doesn't really represent a brake line, very much, you can ignore that node and then hit add all, and it's essentially going to add all the normal, as you see here, it adds all the normal brake lines and ignores that ignored brake line. So I'm going to do that by clicking add all. There's my three brake lines. I can now close my command, and I have 3D line strings for each one of those spots on the curb. So that's a run through on the extract line feature for curb and gutter. Saves a ton of time for extracting curb and gutter. Urge you to use that on your roadway scans, and hopefully you learned something beneficial in this demo, and we'll join us again next time. Thank you.